Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Skill Explore, a live webinar series, MPDA Electrical Exam Preparation. This course is exclusively customized for UPDB Electrical Exam. Before going to the presentation, I would like to say a few words about Skill Explore. Actually, it is an interactive online tutorial platform where experts provide customized UPDA MOEB exam preparation courses, especially for Qatar engineers over the internet to crack UPDA MOEB exam in first attempt with success formula. Here I mentioned one quote: if you study here, you can succeed anywhere. Next, I am very happy to introduce myself, Dr. A. Nazir Ali. Currently working as Associate Professor, REC, Anna University, India. I am having 15 years, 6 months teaching experience at various reputed institutions. I received Young Scientist Award from International Journal Gulab. My achievements are secured 9.1 CGPA University second rank in Master of Engineering in Power Electronics and Drives. Myself, a lifetime member in various professional bodies like ISTE, ECS, IJRULA, IJRD, and IANG. Recently received the IEEE Senior Member Award from IEEE. In addition to that, ISO 9001:2015 certified trainer. So far, published 28 papers in national and international journals. Myself delivered 108 guest lectures at various reputed institutions. My team members are Mr. S. Manikanta Prabhu. He has more than 10 years teaching experience. He's a project management expert, currently working as assistant professor at SRM University, India. The other experts, Mr. D. Shyam. He is electronic expert, assistant, currently working as assistant professor, REC, Anna University, India. He also has more than 10 years teaching experience at various reputed institutions. Next, Mr. A.T. Sangara Subramanian. He is the electrical machines and power system engineering expert, currently working as assistant professor, KRCT, Anna University, India. So myself and my team members are guide throughout the entire session and to make you to perform well in the UPDA examination. If you see the Skill Explore motto, you can see that study smart, not hard. So from that, here we can give a lot of practices. Skill Explore master's course provide some 63 mock module tests. If you practice well, you can clear in the first attempt itself. Now I am coming to the electrical engineering master course. This course deals with the three sections. One is electrical, electronics, and project management. Myself handled 9 sections from electrical and 3 sections from electronics. Rest of the sections handled by other experts. Before anything else, preparation is the key to success. Said by Alexander Graham Bell. So regular practice is needed. Surely you can succeed. Now I am going to explain the distributions of questions. Actually, Skill Explore and my team members are collected previous year's question papers, especially from 2014 to till date. From that, we found that the following numbers questions are expected from the different area. Here, I expect 12 questions from electrical, 10 questions from electronics, and 5 questions from project management. Once again, I repeat, we found that these are the expected questions. So it is purely collected from year 2014 to till date. Next, I am going to explain about the electrical engineering master course overall view. Actually, my presentation cover overall view about electrical engineering master course. Why it is skill explore? What is included in skill explore? Okay. If you see any tree, roots are very very important. So for that, the Qatar government, I really appreciate the Qatar government because they announced those who worked at Qatar, engineers must have license. So they must clear this exam. What their expectation is, they are expecting sound knowledge, that means engineering skills, whether the engineers are qualified or not. So for that, they are conducting this type of examinations. So it is a one type of upgrade ourselves, because technologies are the changes every day. So it is necessary to update ourselves. Okay, now I am coming to electrical engineering course. Already said it divided into three area. One is electrical section. Electrical section covered this part. Then electronic section deals with this part. Then another one is project management. Then if you see electrical section, so here we can add a control and instrumentation also. So those who are studied control instrumentation branch, so you can also get benefited if you choose electrical engineering master course. So electrical section deals with electrical fundamentals, AC and DC fundamentals, control and instrumentation, electric circuits and network theorems, electrical machines and drives, electrical power system. So these are the subdivided area for electrical section. Then next for electronics. So here we discussed electronic fundamentals, digital logics and microprocessor, oscillator and timer, amplifier and op-amp, power supplies and radios. Then management. These are the overall view about the electrical engineering master course. Next, I am going to explain the subject weightage, because from that you clearly understand where you concentrate more. Actually, my suggestion is, as the electrical or electronics or control and instrumentation engineers must have knowledge in all fields. Okay, it is necessary for getting license. Okay, at the same time, as electrical engineers, we should know knowledge on all areas. So it surely helps a lot in future. Okay, now I am going to explain the subject-wise distribution. Here also, I like to mention one thing: so how we can frame this subject-wise weightage means based on the previous year's question papers. So how many questions they repeatedly asked. From 2014 to till date. From that, you can see that 4% from AC and DC fundamentals, then 7% from control and instrumentation, 15% from machines and drives, 11% from electrical power system, 11% from electronic devices and fundamentals, 15% from amplifier, oscillator, logic circuit, timers, and communication systems. 11% from microprocessor system and related topics. Then 19% from project management. Because from the beginning itself, I have given clearly 12 questions from the electrical. So why I am showing this subjects and the weightage means, so from that you can clearly understand where you concentrate more and how to get good marks in exam, in UPDA exam. Okay, now I am going to explain electrical related subjects. What are the subjects available in electrical? Actually here connections of previous year's question paper. So how we frame the syllabus means purely based on question paper from 2014 to till date. So first one is electrical engineering fundamentals, AC and DC fundamentals, control and instrumentation, electrical machines and drives, electrical circuits and network theorems, electrical power systems. So next I am going to explain one by one. For example, electrical engineering fundamentals, what are the course modules, then what are the questions they repeatedly asked. Let's see one by one. Okay, so in electrical engineering fundamental, what are the topics covered? So we covered SI units. SI units means, you know, that international system of units. So it is necessary, because if you want to describe the things like time, distance, mass, so it is necessary to standardize some units. So for that they introduced international system of units. Here also I found that some few questions they asked recently. For example, Tesla is a unit of, then unit of current. Then electrical quantities, what are the electrical quantities that are there? Then electrical units. Then electric currents and Ohm's law resistance. So actually electric current, actually in electrical engineering fundamentals, mainly they cover some basics of electrical. How to define the term current, voltage, power, resistance. If I ask the question to anybody, normally they can say IC equal to, what is current? If I ask the question, they say flow of electron in a metal force is called current. The unit of current is amps. But at the same time, you should know that another definition also, the theoretical definition, IC equal to rate of change of charge with respect to time, IC equal to dq by dt. So the another unit for current is coulombs per second. We know that charge, the unit of charge is coulomb. So coulombs per second, it is another unit of current. The next thing is potential or potential difference or voltage. Both are same. How to define this potential? If you ask this question, many of them may say a potential difference between the two points is called the potential. Apart from that, some other definitions also there. Amount of energy is required to extract an electron from an atomic model or atomic structure is called potential. So theoretical definition, we can say voltage equal to work done divided by charge. So the unit of voltage is volt or joules per coulomb. Joules per coulomb. This is another unit of potential. Then next thing is power, rate of change of energy with respect to time. Power is equal to rate of change of energy with respect to time. Another one is energy. Energy means it's the capacity for doing work. So unit of energy is joules. Then if you see the basic terms, current, voltage, resistance. Resistance means the physical substance which offer to restrict the flow of current or flow of electron is known as resistance. It is denoted by the symbol R. The unit of resistance is Ohm. Then another one unit is that R is equal to rho into L by A. So rho means resistivity, L means length of the conductor, A means area of the conductor. So Ohm per meter, because resistivity R is equal to rho into L by A. Similarly, for other basic terms, inductor, capacitor, then inductor means the energy storage device, it stored energy in the form of magnetic field. Capacitor means it is also energy storage device, it stored energy in the form of electric field. So C is equal to Q by V. Another definition is also available. Then and also we can say two electrodes are separated by a distance is called a capacitor. Okay. Then another one is Ohm's law. So Ohm's law states that at constant temperature, that is very, very important, at constant temperature, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to a potential across a conductor. Potential across a conductor. So V is directly proportional to I. So V is equal to IR. R is the proportionality constant. R is the proportionality constant. Ohm's law is only applicable for constant temperature conducting materials. So it is not applicable for non-linear devices like diodes, transistors, etc. Then resistance are connected in series and parallel. So how to find the total resistance value, etc. So almost here we can cover all the topics, voltage divider circuits, current divider circuits. Everything can be covered under electrical engineering fundamentals. Then and also here I can show one circle. So from that you can suppose if you know the if you want to find power, if you know any of the two values, either if you know voltage and current, we can find power, or if you know voltage resistance, we can use this formula, or if you know current and resistance, you can use this formula. So similarly for current, resistance, voltage, this is the way we can find the electrical quantity: current, voltage, power, resistance. Then and also one more important thing, if you see any tree, the basic roots of electricity are current, power, resistance, voltage. Okay, how we can define in practical way? Practical way means, so if you consider a water tank, how we can define the electrical terms like potential, current, resistance, phase. Pump is used to generate pressure, which is used to force the water. Pump is used to generate pressure, which is used to force the water. Similarly, in electrical, battery is used to generate pressure to force the electron. That is called a potential. So it causes flow of water in mechanical system. Here it causes flow of electron. Then next another one is water flow controlled by connecting one valve. By closing or adjust or by closing or opening the valve, we can control the water level. Similarly, electrical resistance. A resistance which is connected in series or parallel, we can control the circuits. Okay. Now I am going to explain some frequently asked, recently asked questions, especially from the last week. Okay. So here you can see that Tesla is a unit of. So four answer is given: field strength, inductance, flux density, flux. We know that flux density is equal to flux per area. Flux density is equal to magnetic flux density is equal to flux per area. So we can say flux, the unit of flux is Weber, Weber per meter square, Weber per meter square. Or we can say Tesla. But here they can give, suppose if it is Weber per meter square means you can choose flux density, or Tesla means you can choose flux density. So both are same. Okay, the next another one is a very, very important question. Here three lamps are in circuit as shown in figure given below. The lamp of 100 watts will have maximum brightness when. So they are asking when this 100 watts bulb glow brighter. So actually here it is 220 volts. Assume that this is not watt, this is 220 volts. Here these two lamps are connected in parallel, and this combination is connected in series with the 40 watt. Then some switches also connected. Okay. They asked when 100 watts bulb glow brighter or maximum brightness. Okay. So normally you know that if suppose I hope that everybody know that the series and parallel combination. For example, you forget about these things. These two lamps are connected in parallel. Two lamps are connected in parallel. One is 100 watt and another one is 40 watt. Which lamp glow brighter? So when it is in parallel means surely this 100 watts bulb glow brighter because of low resistance. Because of low resistance. Suppose this 100 watts and 40 watts connected in series, which bulb glow brighter? Means this 40 watt bulb glow brighter because its resistance value is high. Its resistance value is high. Okay. So once again, I repeat, So if you are circuit having only two bulbs, these two bulbs are connected in parallel across 220 volt supply. Which bulb glow brighter means, so 100 watts bulb glow brighter because of low resistance. You know the formula. So we know the voltage, we know the power. How to find the resistance? P is equal to V squared by R. So if you calculate that, then you may get 484 ohm. But in the case of 40 watts, you can get 1210 ohm. So in parallel circuit, so 100 watts bulb glow brighter than 40 watts bulb. Suppose if it is connected in series, you forget about these things. If it is connected, two bulbs are connected in series with 220 volts, which bulb glow brighter? So normally 40 watts because its resistance value is high. So more voltage drop, high power dissipation. Okay. So coming to this question, three lamps are in circuit as shown in figure given below. They are asking when 100 watts bulb give maximum brightness. Okay. Four answer is given when K1 is closed. So you can close K1 and K2 is open. So K2 is open and K3 is closed. So this one closed, this one closed. So what happened? Surely these two are connected in parallel, then series. So surely you can't get maximum brightness. Okay. Then see the another one condition. K1 is open. So K1 is open. K2 is closed. K3 is open. Just this one, you know that in open circuit condition, so there is no current flow through the circuit. So here it is no zero current, so here also zero current, so it is a closed path only. 220 volt, then 100 watts amp, 100 watts bulb is connected. So next, third answer is K1 is open. Suppose if K1 is open, K3 is closed, then K3 is closed. Then here also this bulb won't give a maximum brightness. Then K1 is closed, K2 is open, K3 is open. So here it is connected parallel. So right answer is B. When K1 is open, K3 is open, K2 only closed. Okay. Then next, another. Once again, I repeat, these questions taken recently conducted by Qatar government. We have three resistance value, 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 6 ohm. Which of the combination will give an effective resistance of 4 ohm? Actually, here they are asking, you can connect whatever it be, you can connect as it is, as per your connector series or parallel, whatever it may be. But I need the total resistance should be 4 ohm. So how to connect it? So for that, here they given some four answer. All three resistance in series, 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 6 ohm. Then you know that three resistance are connected in series means additive. So sum of these three resistance equal to total resistance. So 2 ohm plus 6 ohm plus 3 ohm plus 6 ohm equal to 11 ohm. So option A is not correct. Then if it is connected in parallel, surely the net resistance 1 by RT is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So 1 by 2, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6. So net resistance value should be less than this 4 ohm. So option B also not corrected. Then option C. A 2 ohm resistor in series with the parallel combination of 3 ohm and 6 ohm. You can see that here, these 3 and 6 ohms are connected in series, parallel. What happens? 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 3. This is the formula for two resistors are connected in parallel. 6 into 3 divided by 6 plus 3. So 18 by 9. So if you cancel, you can get 18 by 9. Here you can see that. Okay, so 2 ohm plus 2 ohm. So answer is 4 ohm. So that option is correct. Then if you see that fourth one, 2 ohm, 2 ohm, so 2 into 6, 12 divided by 8, you get some answer. Then plus 3 ohm, which is not equal to effective resistance of 4 ohm. So answer is C. Then next one is, which one of the following is not correct based on Ohm's law? So I request the participants, I request the delegates, kindly read the question paper carefully, because sometimes what happens is we can tick that which of the following is correct on Ohm's law answer. So you read the questions carefully, then answer. So you know that Ohm's law, at constant temperature, current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to a potential across a conductor. So I is directly proportional to V, V is equal to IR. Okay. Here you can see that V is equal to IR. So this is exact statement. So this is correct statement. Then I is equal to V by R. This is also exact statement. Then R is equal to V by A. A also exact statement. But you can see that R is equal to I by V. So this is not correct. This is not Ohm's law. So you can choose B is equal option B. Okay. Then next, another one is conductance expressed in terms of. So you know that conductance is the reciprocal of the resistance, is called a conductance. So its unit is mho. Its unit is mho. Resistance, mho. Resistivity. Okay. In which of the following circuit voltage source produce more currents? Which of the following circuit voltage source produce more currents? So if you see that here 10 volt across 10 ohm resistance, what happens? So I is equal to V by R, so 1 amps. Next to 10 volt across 2 10 ohm resistance connected in parallel. So what happens? 2 resistance are connected in parallel. So 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 2. So answer will be here 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 10. So 100 divided by 25. 100 divided by 25. So I is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. Then 10 divided by 0.2, you can get 50 amps. Then 10 volt across 10 ohm resistance are connected in series. 2 10 ohms. So I is equal to V by R. So 10 divided by 20, you can get some 0.5 amps. Similarly, here also I is equal to V by R, you can get very less amount of current. So answer will be B. Okay. Next, another one is a very important question, an interesting question. We have a resistance R1 and R2. Resistance value is 4.5 ohm. When it is connected in series 1 ohm, I have two resistance, R1, R2. Okay. Resistance value is 4.5 ohm when it is connected in series. Then 1 ohm resistance when it is connected in parallel. Okay, what is the R1, R2 value? We know that R1 plus R2 equal to 4.5. R1 plus R2 equal to 4.5. So here you can see the answer, which is 4.5, 3 ohm plus 5, 8. Then 1.5 plus 3, you can get 4.5 ohm. The next another one is 2.5 into 2 equal to 4.5. Then another one is 3.5. So two options may be chance. Two options may be the possible. So which one is correct? Then next you will go for another one. R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 equal to 1. If two resistors are connected in parallel, so the formula for total resistance is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Equal to 1 ohm, they given. Then R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 equal to 1 ohm. R1 plus R2, you know the value, 4.5 ohm. So from that, R1 plus R1 R2 equal to 4.5 ohm. Then from that, you substitute in any one of the equation. Then if you find that, so your answer is 1.5 ohm and 3 ohm. So here I can give some hints also. R1, R2, R1 plus R2, 1.5 into 3, 4.5, so equal to 1 ohm. Okay. So answer is 1.5 ohm and 3 ohm. Next, another one is unit of current is unit of current. Here they given three answers: ampere, volt, ohm, or any other answer. So obviously we know that ampere is the unit of current. Okay. So far we discussed some electrical engineering fundamentals. What are the topics covered? Then what are the questions they repeatedly asked in the UPDA exam? Okay. So now I am going to enter AC and DC fundamentals. So in DC fundamentals, here we are covered some wave shaping circuits like CR circuits and LR circuits. So how it is working, then based on few problems, everything discussed in this section. Next, another one is AC fundamentals. So here discussed about the sinusoidal waveform, then basic terms like form factor, peak factor, RMS value, based on a few problems. Then similarly, when AC source is connected across inductor, what happens? When AC source is connected across RL circuit, when AC source is connected across RC, RLC, then how to find impedance value, current, phase angle, power factor. Then we know that different types of AC power, apparent power, active power, then reactive power. Everything can be find from this area. Then last one is resonance circuit. So resonance, obviously you know that XL is equal to XC. The resonance occurred when XL is equal to XC, inductive reactance equal to capacitive reactance. Here we discussed about some different types of resonance circuits, series resonance and parallel resonance. At resonant condition, you know what about the power factor value of UVT and Z equal to R. Then in series circuit, how it is performed, how to find resonant frequency, bandwidth, quality factor, then based on few problems, similarly for parallel resonance circuits also. So everything can be discussed this section, AC and DC fundamentals. Then next, frequently asked questions, which of the following is non-linear device? You know that, so condenser, sometimes we can call it as capacitor, inductance, wire wound resistor. So another one is transistor, because they are asking non-linear device. So non-linear device means, so the device which does not obey the Ohm's law or superposition principle is called non-linear. So from that, the exact answer is transistor. Then next one, another one is, which of the following method may be used to convert AC system to DC system? So actually here four answers are available, rectifier, inverter, cycloconverter, all of the above. We know that rectifier, so the function of rectifier is convert fixed AC into fixed DC. If you are using diode, you can get fixed AC to fixed DC. But if you are using some power semiconductor devices like ACR, MOSFET, IGBT, you can get variable DC outputs. Variable DC output, that is called a controlled rectifier. That is called a controlled rectifier. Then next, another one is inverter. So inverter means it convert fixed DC into variable voltage and variable frequency. So it is also not a correct answer. Cycloconverter is a frequency type converter. It converts fixed frequency into variable frequency. So all of the above is also not exact answer. So which option is correct? Means so option A is correct, because a rectifier only which convert AC to DC. Okay, then next another one is an ideal voltage source have zero internal resistance, whether it is true or not. Yes, it is true, because none of the power is wasted due to internal resistance. If the internal resistance will be more, means more drop will be there. So for that it's too difficult to find. So for that, in ideal voltage source has zero internal resistance. So it is true. So here I can give the explanation also. Next, another one is a sine wave has a frequency of 50 hertz. Its angular frequency is dash radians per second. So we know the formula for angular frequency. 2 pi f. Omega is equal to 2 pi f. So from that, frequency value is given, 50 hertz. They are asking omega, how to find angular frequency. So angular frequency, omega is equal to 2 pi f. So 2 pi into 50. So answer is 100 pi. So here four options are there, 100 pi, 50 pi, 25 pi. So option A is correct, 100 pi, option A is correct. Okay, then next another one is a very important because the most of the electrical engineer must know power factor. So power factor is defined as the cosine angle between current and voltage. Many formulas are there. Another one is active power divided by apparent power. It is denoted by the simple cos pi. Power factor play a major role in electrical, especially when you are using inductive load. Normally, if you are using resistive load, means power factor is unity. Then, if you are using inductive load means power factor is lagging. If you are using capacitor, means capacity load means power factor is leading. In general, power factor is defined as cosine angle between current and voltage, or active power divided by apparent power. We know the formula for active power, VI cos pi, then apparent power VI. So VI, VI cancel, finally you can get cos pi. Next, another is the control and instrumentation. So control system, what is control system? System output is controlled by varying the any other quantity or input manner is called the control system. Two types of control systems are there. One is the open loop control system and another one is the closed loop control system. Example for open loop control system, traffic lights, we can say example. Output quantity has no effect upon the input quantity. Then the system is called open loop control system. Closed loop system means output quantity has effect upon the input quality. And also another one important thing, the changes in error due to external disturbance are corrected automatically. Then that's why it is also called as closed loop system is also called as automatic control system. So if you see that, if you see this block diagram, this one represents the exact definition of closed loop system. Because it requires sensor, we can sense the output, then again given to the input. Output is fed to the input is called the feedback. Okay. Next, another one is instrumentation. Instrumentation is a piece of apparatus which is used to measure the unknown quantity. For example, current, voltage, power. So if you want to measure current with the help of ammeter, we can measure the current. Voltmeter, we can measure the voltage. Okay, what are the topics covered here? In control system, block diagram reduction and signal flow graph, stability analysis, P, PA and PID controllers, compensators. Then next one is measurement and instrumentation. So how to measure the resistance value, inductance value, capacitance value. Then measurement of current, voltage, power, energy, and power factor. The apart from this instrument, transformers, sensors, and transducers. So how it is working, then constructions, then applications, everything discussed here. Control and instrumentation section. Okay. Which of the following should be done to make an unstable system to be stable? Normally, the term, if you know that the term stability refers stable working condition of a system. If you want to purchase anything, three things are very, very essential. One is speed. Second one is accuracy. Third one is stability. So in order to achieve the stability, the first step in design procedure is adjustment of gain. While adjust the gain, sometimes system may cause poor stability. So for that, I think it's one of the interesting question. So for that, you may be studied some Rauter's criterion method, then other methods to how to say whether the system is stable or not. Okay. Here the answer is, here they given four answers. The gain of the system should be decreased. gain of the system should be increased. The number of poles to the loop transfer function should be increased. Number of zeros to the loop transfer function should be increased. Okay. Here, so the gain of the system should be increased to make unstable system to stable system. For that, you can provide positive feedback. So in positive feedback system, gain will be more. So negative feedback system, gain is reduced. Gain is reduced. So from that, you clearly understand, you can choose option B. Then next, another one is DAS is an example of closed loop system. Autopilot for aircraft, direct current generator, car starter, electric switch. So you can see this B, C, D almost is equivalent to open circuits, open loop system. So autopilot system, so here only we can detect the rate of movement and detect the displacement, then again send the signal to the input, then again we can correct. Then this is called autopilot for an aircraft is the best example of a closed loop control system. Okay, now I'm going to tell one story, because if I'm saying continuously, it may be boring, because why you prefer skill explore. From the story itself, you can clearly understand. Okay, just 2 minutes only. Okay, a man who carried buffalo on his shoulder. A man who carried buffalo on his shoulder. Could you imagine that, whether it is possible to carry buffalo on our shoulder? It is not possible. One day, and he is regularly walking from a particular distance, exactly 1 kilometer. People, those who are standing roadside, they were astonished how this gentleman carry buffalo on his shoulder and walk from here to the particular distance, which is approximately equal to 1 kilometer. He carry buffalo walking from 1 kilometer. So it is too, too difficult for us. Then one gentleman, he asked the particular guy, so how it is possible? He simply replied, when it is in child, I start this practice. I never feel burden. He said, I start this practice when it is in child. I never feel burden. Okay, story is over. What do you understand from this story? Story is, practice does not make perfect. Regular practice makes you perfect. For that, you can prepare accordingly. So this type of skill explore master course, surely, because the skill explore master electrical course exclusively customized 63 module live mock tests. 63 mock tests. Each module consists of 27 questions. So just you calculate 63 into 27. You calculate how many questions you practiced. Apart from that, after end of the session, some sample quiz question also available. From that, whether what you understand from the particular session, and how to correct yourself, how to improve further. So for that, I am saying, many of them think that I have knowledge, so I am cleared. But okay, if you have that, there is no problem. But otherwise, you need some guidance. So for that, Skill Explore support you and guide you. Then myself and my team members are throughout the session will be available to guide you and to make perform you to be better in the UPDA examination. Okay. From this question, if you see some questions, you can understand it is too difficult to answer. For example, the Bode plot for the circuit shown, A is equal to V2 by V1. Here they given one integrated circuits. Then apart from that, they given 4 answers. Okay, so what is Bode plot? So it is a frequency response plot. It usually drawn on a semi-log sheet. It consists of 2 graphs. One graph drawn between magnitude in decibel versus frequency. Another one graph drawn between phase versus frequency. Here they given frequency versus phase. It's a frequency versus gain. Gain in decibel graph. Okay. then if you see that so here the output v output is equal to the formula is minus xc divided by r into v in. Then this is the exact answer. So it is act like a low pass filter. It is act like a curve is like a low pass filter. So when frequency is zero, because we know that xc is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi fc. When frequency is zero, it is equal to open loop gain. Open loop gain. When the frequency increases, gain gradually decreases. Gain gradually decreases. So after a particular point, so it will be saturated. It will be saturated. So here four options are there. So you can choose option D. This question also the last week they asked from UPDA examination. So I have taken from that. Okay. Then next another one is the electrical machines and drives. So here we covered types of DC motors, DC generators, transformers, alternators, induction motors, synchronous motors. So here we covered DC motor. What are the different types of DC? Generally, we know that motor means which convert electrical energy into mechanical energy. Basic principle of operation is based on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Faraday's law says that whenever current carrying conductor is placed between the magnetic field, it experiences force. The force direction can be found by Fleming left hand rule. Fleming left hand rule. So here we discussed about what are the types of DC motors, constructional details of DC motors, torque equations of DC motors, few problems based on DC motors, what are the factors affecting the motor speed control and its methods of speed control, everything can be discussed. Then here are similarly for generators, transformers, alternators, induction motors, and synchronous motors. Okay. So the power factor of an alternator depends on. So four options are given: load, speed of the rotor, core loss, armature loss. Okay. So from that you can understand, especially power factor is purely based on load. The power factor of an alternator depends on load. So the power factor of alternator depends on nature of the load connected. Suppose if it is connected in inductive nature, if you are connecting inductive load means power factor is lagging. Already said capacity load means so power factor is leading. Then another one is a very important question. Induction motor is running at stability. Running at stability, slip should not be. So slip should not be 1, 0, both A and B none. Okay. Actually, if it is slip should be 0 means what happens? N S minus N is equal to 0. So it should not be 0. So induction motor running at stability means slip should not be 0. It has some value. It has some value. It may be either less than 1 or 1. Then another one is synchronous motor. So synchronous motor is rotated constant speed. Even if you apply any load, the main advantage of synchronous motor is synchronous motor operate at various power factor like lagging, leading, and unity power factor. Lagging, leading, unity, power factor. Then synchronous motor rotate at constant speed even apply any load. The major drawback of synchronous motor is not self-starting. So in order to make the self-starting, many arrangements can be used. So pony motor arrangements or some coupled motor, damper windings, etc. Okay. So here synchronous motor said to be over-excited means so you know that leading power factor, leading power factor. So in DC, because synchronous motor require DC excitation, in DC field excitation synchronous motor such that back EMF is greater than the applied voltage. So back, what is back EMF? Back EMF means when the armature conductor rotate, it cuts the field flux and EMF is induced. That induced EMF is opposed to applied voltage. That is called the back EMF. So here back EMF is greater than the applied voltage, then the motor is said to be over excited. Okay, at this condition power factor is leading. Okay, then next another one is universal motor. Actually it can be operated both AC and DC power supply. So and option is C. Okay, next another one is electrical circuits and network theorems. Actually here we covered some basic electrical circuits. So you know The purpose of electric circuit is transfer electrical energy from source to load. If you see any electrical circuit, it consists of three main parts. One is source, another one is load. Then transfer electrical energy from battery to a source to load with the help of two wires. That is called basic electric circuits. Okay, what are the other different types of circuits are there? Means active, passive, linear, non-linear, lumped and distributed, unilateral and bilateral. Everything can be discussed this section. So in addition to that, some basic laws, Kirchhoff current law, Kirchhoff voltage law, then few problems based on both laws, then theorems. So here we discussed not superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, maximum power transfer theorem, Millman's theorem, etc. For example, if you see that here, if you see this circuit, Thevenin's equivalent circuit, you know the Thevenin's theorem statement. Almost the purpose of all theorem is to find load currents. In Thevenin's theorem, IL is equal to V Thevenin divided by R Thevenin plus RL. Okay. Before that, we discussed mesh analysis and nodal analysis. Because if you have strong knowledge in mesh analysis, nodal analysis, current division technique and voltage division technique, only you are able to solve well in theorems. Actually, they are asking only simple problem only. But only thing is, if you understand the concept thoroughly, you can solve any problem within a fraction of seconds. Next, another one is three-phase circuits. So here we discussed some balanced circuit, unbalanced circuits, star connections, delta connections, then the power factor measurement. Everything can be discussed in this section. Electrical circuits and network theorems. Okay, so the algebraic sum of current meet at any junction is called, you know that, Kirchhoff current law. Normally, when I ask the students state Kirchhoff current law, so we can get some different answers. One is incoming current is equal to outgoing currents. Current entering into the junction is equal to current leaving that junction. Current flowing towards a junction is equal to current flow away from that junction. But the exact statement is algebraic sum of current meet at any junction is called zero. Summation I is equal to zero. Another one is Kirchhoff voltage law. So Kirchhoff voltage law states that in any closed circuit or mesh or node, the algebraic sum of voltages taken around is zero. So for our understanding purpose, we can say potential drops equal to potential rise. Then other Thevenin's theorem, Park's theorem, but here answer is option A, sorry, not C. So wrongly put, here option is A. So Kirchhoff current law. Then next, another one is concept of superposition theorem. So it is purely based on linearity principle. So we know that superposition theorem states that in any linear network containing two or more sources, the algebraic sum of the response caused by individual source acting alone while other sources are non-operative. So while solving superposition theorem, we need minimum two sources. Step number one, using one source, you can find the current flow through the particular path. Then step number two, using another source, you can find the current flow through the second path. Then step number three, find the current flow due to both sources. You can add the two values. Okay. So here answer is linearity. Okay, next another one is Norton's theorem. So you know that Norton's theorem. So Norton's theorem states that in any linear network or bilateral consists of current source, voltage source, resistance can be replaced by an equivalent circuit consists of current source in parallel with the resistance. Current source in parallel with the resistance or current source in parallel with the impedance. Thevenin's theorem means voltage source in series with the resistance. Norton's theorem means current source in parallel with the resistance or impedance. So here you can see that equivalent current source and impedance in series. This is not correct. equivalent current source and impedance in parallel. One answer, equivalent impedance, equivalent current. So option B is correct. Option B is correct. Next, Millman's theorem. Actually, Millman's theorem, the concept of Millman's theorem is they given many voltage source connected in series with the resistor. So you have to simplify or find the simple single equivalent source, single equivalent voltage source. That is the concept of Millman's theorem. So for that, it may be the single voltage source or single current source. So option D is correct. Okay, next another one is electrical power system. Actually, here we can discuss about power system means you know that conveyance of electric power from power station to consumer premises, that is called power system. Here we discuss about transmission and distribution, then per unit problems, then circuit breakers, then SCADA. Then which circuit breaker is most commonly used in distribution level? So not only distribution, most of the applications they are using only air circuit breakers because it is simple and economical. Simple and economical. Then next another one is by which of the following systems electric power may be transmitted? So actually here by which of the following systems electric power may be transmitted? Here four options are there. One is overhead system, and another one is underground system, and another one is both A and B. So none of the above. So actually here the overhead system, underground system, both are right answer. So for that both A and B option is available. So you can choose option C. The next another one is the underground system cannot be operated above 440 volt, 11 kV, 33 kV, 66 kV. So option is D, 66 kV, because of insulation difficulties. But overhead system can be designed for operation up to 400 kV. The next another one is the SCADA system configurations uses input from an instrument. Trichelvam. Hello. Okay. The SCADA system configuration uses input from an instrument, current transformer with the ratio of 100:5. The transducer supplying the SCADA has a full scale AC current value of 2.5 amps. What is the most nearly the maximum current in the primary side of the current transformer? Actually, here you know the formula for tens ratio. So a tens ratio is 10/5. Then primary current I1 divided by I2 is equal to. But they are asking primary side of the current transformer. So IB is equal to 2.5 into this ratio. So 50 amps is the right answer. So here you can choose option B is correct. Okay. Then next another one is the circuit breaker is here. So current interrupting device, power factor correcting device, harmonic correcting device, all of the above. Actually, so circuit breaker is a current interrupting device. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Okay. What is included in Skill Explore Master Course? Actually, I hope that so far you clearly understand the overall view about electrical engineering course. Then and also I can show some frequently asked questions. Okay. What is included in Skill Explore Master Course? Almost here, if you choose Skill Explore Master Course, first benefit is lifetime access. So throughout the lifetime you can access. That is the first advantage. The second one is 27 session recorded video session is available. So already I said the expert myself and D. Shyam and Sankar Subramanian, then project management experts. So all experts videos are recorded and upload here. Then in addition to that, e-study materials also available. e-study material. So record video session, then about the presentation. Next one is already I said, so skill explore, exclusively customized this UPDA course. So for that 63 module live mock test is available, 63 modules live mock test. Each module consists of 27 questions. So 27 into 63, you can calculate so how much questions you can practice. Then live quiz on each session. After completing session one, some sample quiz questions also available. It may be 5 to 6 questions may be available. You can practice it. From that, you can understand what you learned from that particular session. Then it is also helpful to perform better in examination. Then next thing is complete syllabus coverage for your examination. I hope that you know that there is no syllabus for UPDMOEB examination. So Skill Explore Master Course collected previous year's question, especially from 2022 till date. From that we framed the syllabus. Almost we can covered all the portions of electrical, electronics, and control into instrumentation. Then explained here. Then finally, they provided free documentation and consultant support for your examinations. Then, if you are having any queries, please contact. Cell number is available here. Then email ID info@skillexplore.com. Then website, you can refer the website www.skillexplore.com. Here the electrical engineering fundamentals, the base session one video is also available, so it is free. You can download and see my presentation, give your valuable feedback. So it is surely correct as I wish everyone to make perform well in the examination. Wish you all the best. Thank you for your patient listening. If you are having any queries, please ask.